Peace and love. Welcome. Come on in. Welcome to the dynasty. Yes, let's get into this energy. Sagittarius. Yeah, let's go. Let's get into it. I know I have been procrastinating when it comes to tapping into your energy. I've been so busy. But you have been on my mind. Believe it. Okay. We're going to go ahead and get into this energy and see what's happening with the Sag, okay? My beautiful ones, we're going to jump right into the tarot. I'm not going to waste any time. I hope you are doing beautiful. I hope you are doing lovely. My new subscribers, welcome to the channel. Yes, let's build this channel up. And thank you for becoming a part of the dynasty, okay? Becoming a subscriber. So let's get into this energy, my beautiful ones. Let's go ahead and see what my Sagittarius is up to. What it says in the ethers is happening around you all. I hope you're doing beautiful, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm protected by my host of angels, my spirit guides, my ancestors, as I channel these messages. Card spirit for Sagittarius. Thank you. This came out crossing. I'll go ahead and put them upright. This one is in reverse. Let's talk about it. We got the Ten of Cups in the reverse, Sagittarius. Mm-hmm. We got the Page of Wands that is in the upright, the High Priestess in the upright, as well as the Seven of Cups in the reverse. Okay, let's get into this energy. Let's talk about it some more. Remember to take what is yours and leave what is not. Check your sun, moon, rising, as well as Venus, okay? Anywhere that this energy may lie in your chart. Get into it, all right? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, let's talk about it some more. More cards. Yes, sweet. Sagittarius. Okay. One more card. Ooh. Too many more cards, but the first one down is the one that gets it. Mm-hmm. Talk about it. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about this energy, my beautiful Sagittarius. Again, I hope you're doing fine. I hope you are doing well. And I hope you are feeling lovely. Mm-hmm. Ten of Cups is upside down. This is somebody's home, okay? This is your place where you find your happiness, all right? This place of fulfillment is disharmonious. There is no harmony in this place, okay? Wherever this place may be, there are members that are supposed to be as a unit that are in separation. And there's a Page of Wands energy that's here, and it lets us know that there is someone, Sagittarius, who is really expansive with their mind and thoughts, the things that they want to do. They're very inventive. They want to create something new. And they may want to create something new with a High Priestess. However, they may be in this energy of knowing, okay, that the Seven of Cups that's in the reverse, they're in the cup. In the energy of knowing, because these Seven of Cups are in reverse. So in the upright, this is illusions, okay? This is confusion that is happening, but it's in the reverse. So this High Priestess energy is the Sagittarius knowing, okay? Knowing all the things that, you know, they probably once saw was real or true, were really just make-believe. Mm-hmm. And there is an energy of feeling left out in the cold now, along with some financial heartache that may be attached with this in this energy, okay? Sagittarius, Five of Pentacles is here. And the Ace of Wands is in reverse. And I mean, we don't want any aces in the reverse, okay? However, we have an Ace of Wands that's in reverse. And this is more creativity, okay? This is more creativity. This is more inspiration. Mm-hmm. So due to this lack of, you know, feeling left out in the cold, as well as feeling a lack of financial security, there is someone that is no longer in this energy of creating anything, okay? This energy is not being creative, all right? With this Ace of Wands in the reverse. We got the Fool, okay? This energy is an energy of taking chances, uh-huh? And they're wanting to take a chance and move towards someone, someplace, somewhere. The Chariot is here, all right? So this is what we're working with. This is the energy that is out here. The overall energy is a King of Cups. We're dealing with a masculine energy that is in their emotions. Flip and switch these energies, okay? However, your story, take what is yours and take what is not, okay? And leave it alone if it's not yours. So let's talk about this Ten of Cups that's in the reverse. This is, you know, people are not happy here, okay? Ten of Cups, Spirit. Thank you. Came out crossing, but I'm gonna hold it upright. Mm-hmm. Spirit is saying keep it upright. This is the Hierophant. This was the Most High that came into play. Uh-huh. The Hierophant is about all about commitment. All right? And let's point out, you have two individuals that are looking up to this individual. So this is a higher, okay, perspective, right? So this is Source, okay? This is something that was created. This Ten of Cups that we see in reverse, this was literally some alchemy put in place to create this. And the overall energy is the Wheel of Fortune is also in the reverse. So the outcome of this Ten of Cups being in the reverse, disharmony, really just, you know, a bunch of disputes and unhappiness happening. This was orchestrated by the Most High. Just as this Wheel of Fortune in the reverse, which is connected to the destiny. So this is all about someone fated their own destiny. Let's talk about it. Spirit, why is the Hierophant here? Oh, okay. Oh, because of the Tower. Mm-hmm. Yeah. There's a Tower that is no doubt is in motion, okay? Mm-hmm. We got the Hierophant at the bottom of overall energy. This Tower is happening. And it's happening due to someone committing to the wrong cause. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the wrong cause. They're in hermit mode right now. Mm-hmm. Whatever that means, whether they're going in or whether they're looking to see how did everything that they created through manipulation of alchemy backfire. Because the light is shining bright on it. Uh-huh. It's not hard to tell. That's what Spirit is telling me. People are seeing this Tower. And boy, is it being felt. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about this Page of Wands. Page of Wands. Page of Wands. Somebody had an idea. Ooh, okay. Whoa. Oh, look what jumped out together. Somebody had an idea, Sagittarius. Someone had a bright idea. And because of this idea, it left them in a lot of grief and a lot of sadness. Uh-huh. This Page of Wands energy is in a lot of grief and a lot of sadness behind this. Uh-huh. Yeah. Somebody used their magic and it's not so magical. Mm-hmm. Somebody used their magic possibly to get a new beginning. Mm-hmm. A solid beginning. Let's talk about it. Why is the Five of Cups here? Spirit, Five of Cups for Sag. Sagittarius. There we go. There we go. Let's get to the root. Let's get right to the root. Okay. Mm-hmm. Sagittarius. Don't tell me you were making magic with the devil. Who is this in your energy? Mm-hmm. Let's talk about it. Because it brought nothing but a struggle on. Mm-hmm. Someone's in the energy playing with the devil with some magic, okay? Take what is yours, leave what is not. It's going down. And it's a tower. That is the proof of the putting. Mm-hmm. And because this High Priestess energy is here, let's go ahead and tap into the High Priestess and see, hey, did they know what I think they didn't know? The High Priestess. High Priestess. Why is the High Priestess here? Oh, okay. So this is the Eight of Cups and it's in reverse. Someone is stuck. Someone is stagnant. Someone is not able to wiggle. Mm-hmm. This is what it's looking like. This is someone that had a fear of changing. They tried to avoid change and they didn't want to let go of this energy of the devil. Let's talk about it some more. Oh, wow. And it has everything to do with Three of Swords. Sagittarius. Everything to do with the Three of Swords. Wow. Okay. I want to tap into the devil again. The devil. Thank you, Spirit. Sagittarius. Yeah. It's brought a lot of anxiety, grief, nightmares, can't sleep at night, mental illness behind this energy of the devil. Somebody's magic was not magical. This is the truth, though, okay? That's what this is. This is clarity. This is nothing but the truth. So help me, God. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about it. Okay. Yeah. Someone's been drinking. Uh-huh. Yeah, somebody's drinking a little bit too much these days. Yeah. There's some addictions going on. Can't sleep at night because of it. Sag, y'all setting it off. I mean, straight off the bat, you know. If this is you and your energy, we're going to dissect this, definitely. However, if this is someone in your energy, we're going to dissect it either way it goes. Yeah. Let's talk about it some more. Eight of Cups in reverse, Spirit. Eight of Cups in reverse. The stagnation, this, you know, inability to want to change, okay, because of the attachment to the devil that has brought everything down. A Ten of Cups is in the reverse, but it was unhappy, okay? And it was only, it's divine timing according to the Hierophant being here, okay? Let's talk about it. Eight of Cups in reverse. Thank you. Yeah, it sounds about right. So this Eight of Cups is in reverse. This is, you know, there was no reciprocity. This is Six of Pentacles that's in the reverse, all right? This is about being generous and giving to others, mm-hmm, that, you know, are looking to be given to, right? Mm-hmm. But the Six of Pentacles in reverse is about somebody being unfair. And every time you gave to someone, they expected a return. So every time you give, it was someone expecting a return. Spirit tells me somebody was let down. And it could be a Knight of Wands energy. Mm-hmm. Sagittarius. Mm-hmm. Fire signs. Let's talk about it. All right. So we got this Seven of Cups, that's in the reverse. There's no more illusions, conclusions, delusions, confusions. There's none of that anymore, right? Okay. Tell the spirit, Seven of Cups in reverse. Seven of Cups in reverse. What came out? Oh, King of Wands, okay. Mm-hmm. So the King of Wands is the energy that was confused. This is Sagittarius energy, right? There was confusion. Mm-hmm. And it was confusion when it came to a new love. Yeah. Overall energy is the Ace of Cups. Mm-hmm. This is new love. This is really a new life when you get this new love, because this is new feelings. And this is about this King of Wands tapping into his spiritual energy as well as his compassionate side. And it seems to have been a bit of confusion around that. King of Wands, spirit, King of Wands. Oh, okay. A Knight of Wands. So this King of Wands was in the energy of a knight, and that could very well be the issue, right? This is someone that, you know, wants to be a quick hero, a quickie, okay? Moving in and moving out quickly, all right? And the horse is heavy, uh-huh. The horse is heavy. Yeah. Wow. This energy could have traveled, all right? Mm-hmm. And is looking to expand at the same time. Mm-hmm. Energy of expansion. Right here. So there's a King of Wands is very passionate about having an expansion. And what it is, the magic that was practiced within this energy led to a lot of letdowns, heartbreaks, and headaches is what I'm seeing. Somebody's whole world is turned upside down in this energy. Let's talk about it some more. Five of Pentacles, out in the cold, pockets on flat. Five of Pentacles for Sagittarius. What's going on? What's going on? Okay. So this is the Seven of Wands that's in the reverse. Yeah. Okay. So now there's an energy, Sag, that someone is, they feel like defeated. They don't have a belief. You know, they let go of their beliefs of even making anything happen. This is what they call a hyper vigilante, okay? Mm-hmm. Someone that just is lost. I mean, when it comes to like even trying to figure out how did I get here? But spirit is telling me that Sagittarius, you know how this energy got here. Mm-hmm. Someone is feeling defeated. Let's talk about it. Oh, and that's the truth again. There we go. It's also some clarity, right? That's why I said spirit is telling me that, you know, Sag, you know how this energy got here. Take what is yours, leave what isn't. However, we're going to get all the way into it, right? All right, Sagittarius, tell us about the Seven of Wands in reverse. Thank you, spirit. Thank you. Yeah, being the wounded hero, really repetitiously wanting to fight a battle because you believed in a cause that had no cause. This is what this is telling me. They say this is the wounded hero, but if you're wounded and you're continuously wanting to be a hero, this is the side effect of never healing. Yeah. Got Four of Swords in the reverse. Someone has awakened. There is this energy here of someone awakening. Self-reflecting, really thinking about everything that took place. What's going on? All right. Let's talk about it some more. Tell us about it. Tell us about the seven, excuse me, this nine of wands, the wounded hero. Okay, thank you. The wounded hero is a knight of cups in reverse. Wow. Okay. Sagittarius, in your energy, this nine of cups, this knight of cups. This is someone who is very disappointed. But you know what brings on the disappointment? Is someone who expected to perfect something, but it was something created from jealousy. And this person tries to avoid conflict at the same time. So it's like planting a seed and being surprised when it's a garden. Uh-huh. Yeah. Nine of Cups energy in reverse. This person, emotions all over the place. They can't control their emotions. This is where the jealousy, this is where the imbalance comes in at, right? Let's talk about it some more. Sag, Ace of Wands in reverse. Ace of Wands in reverse. Thank you. Mm-hmm. So this is really about planning your future. And this is what this Ace of Wands in reverse means. Because that's a gift from the Most High, okay? Mm-hmm. To just be constantly in the energy of creation, you know, that is a gift, right? Mm. Overall energy is a King of Pentacles. This is a father figure and possible, you know, head of the household energy, right? But let's get back to this Two of Wands. This Two of Wands is telling me, with the Ace of Wands in reverse, you know, this person did not have the opportunity to even make a decision based on what it was that they had in their subconscious mind to go forth with. This is about future planning. This is about, you know, being ready to do something new. Go somewhere outside of your comfort zone. Change your life. This is that energy. And this may be a father figure who is here, okay? Uh-huh. And this father figure may have been wanting to make this change or having this change contemplated, right? In the subconscious mind and energetically, physically for a Nine of Pentacles energy, okay? Let's talk more about it. And we know that she's Miss Independence, right? Miss Nine of Pentacles. Now, let's tap into the Fool. Mm-hmm. What is the Fool here for? Thank you, Spirit. Thank you. Oh, the Fool is here for all the lies and the trickery and all the, you know, treachery that was caused to an Empress. Mm-hmm. Yeah, to an Empress. Wow. I see why the tower, the house is being brought down. Tell us more, Spirit. Oh, look what they did to the Empress. Ten swords. Ten swords to an Empress. Wow. Somebody was tripping. Oh, wow. Okay. Sagittarius. Set it off. Why won't you? Let's see who's really setting it off, right? Seven of Swords, Spirit. Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords, Spirit. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, somebody, again, has awakened to what it is. It came out crossing. Mm-hmm. However, there's an awakening that has happened. Four of Swords in reverse. Somebody knows that they basically messed up their Ten of Pentacles overall energy. Now, this energy is in the energy of thinking about the Ten of Pentacles. And this is legacy. This is, you know, your abundance that you have set up for yourself. This is what life is, you know, really geared towards building, right? When we talk about this here, Ten of Pentacles, this is about you being able to retire a happy woman or a happy man, because you created some stability and you're leaving a legacy, okay? Let's talk about it. Tell us more. Four of Swords in reverse, Spirit. Oh, okay. Oh, the world is here. Closing out a cycle. Mm-hmm. So, is someone is closing out a cycle when it comes to sitting in this? It's as if you have awakened. Sag or someone in your energy has awakened enough to close out a cycle when it comes to this Nine of Pentacles energy, okay? Here goes Miss Luxurious again, Miss Independence, right? Let's talk about it some more. The world, Spirit, the world. Why is the world here? Why is the world here? Because the world could also mean the internet, okay? It could also mean, oh yeah, it means it's over. It's a death, okay? It means there is a death put to a solid beginning in this energy, overall energy, okay? Somebody put a death to their own of closing out this cycle when it came to having a solid beginning for themselves, okay? The Chariot. Why is the Chariot here? And above the Chariot is the Knight of Wands. So, why is the Chariot here, Spirit? For Sag. Oh, okay. For a Queen of Cups, all right? This Queen of Cups energy is someone who is empathetic. A nurturer as well, right? So, let's talk about it. She's on top of the Chariot. So, this Chariot is letting me know that someone wants to move either. They wanted to move forward, right? They want to go towards someone, somewhere. And then we have the Queen of Cups that's here. So, what this is telling me is that this Chariot is in the energy of moving towards their victory. And you have a Queen of Cups that is here in their emotions and in their feelings about someone wanting to move towards their victory. Three of Cups is here, okay? This is a celebration. So let's tap some more into it. Okay. Queen of Cups, Spirit. Why is Queen of Cups here? Oh, okay. I'm taking this one. Oh, but these other ones came out. Putting them back in. We're going to see them again, I'm sure. Yeah, this is a karmic. The Queen of Cups is the karmic. Mm-hmm. This is a Six of Cups in reverse. Now, the Six of Cups in the upright is, you know, someone that feels good, someone that brings nostalgic memories, good memories, okay? This is a past childhood love, sweetheart, someone very dear and near to you, you know, possibly a lifetime or lifetimes ago that you were connected with this energy, okay? But it's in the reverse, so that's a karmic. Mm-hmm. This Queen of Cups energy is someone that was sent here to teach a lesson. And they may have taught you lessons in various lifetimes. However, until you close out the cycle and bring a death to it, you continue to learn these lessons over and over again. Let's talk about it. Oh, and who may be learning these lessons is the Emperor energy. Yeah. There's an Emperor energy, masculine energy who is learning or have learned a very serious lesson with the karmic energy, a Queen of Cups energy. Tell us more about the Six of Cups in reverse. Thank you, Spirit. Six of Cups in reverse. It's the truth, and there's been clarity about Miss Queen of Cups, possible water sign, right? Okay, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, right? Okay, so we got Ace of Swords. This is the truth, They found out the truth when it came to the lovers. Yeah. So there was a Queen of Cups that was feeling some type of way, who is a karmic, okay? And a karmic is somebody, again, who is in your life to teach you a lesson through deceits, lies, mistrust, to teach you all the things that, you know, you teach your children that are bad things to do, right? These are lessons that, unfortunately, in your adulthood, everybody does not get these lessons, okay? Some people are bred off of working and operating in these lessons. So we got the lovers at the bottom of the deck, okay? And they are the truth. Somebody is spying on the lovers, okay? So this is telling me this Queen of Cups energy that we're seeing, they're looking at both energies at this time, okay? And I started to mention this death when it comes to the world is also can be considered for the World Wide Web. So this is, you know, the web, the internet, things that, you know, are communicated in this world. So let's go ahead. Let's tap a little further into it. All right. Let's get it. Let's go. All right. Ace of Swords. Tell us about the truth. Ace of Swords, Spirit. Ace of Swords. Give us more truth. Thank you. Yeah. What I said is the truth. Spying. And watching. A Queen of Cups. Currently in this energy, and they're worried about what the Knight of Swords is going to do. Now, this is an assertive energy that just wants to make something happen, okay? And they want to do it fast. They want to do it fast because they really just want to be your knight in shining armor, and they want to change their life. This is what this Knight of Swords is all about. They want to change their life. Yeah. And I mean, not so sure about the knight in shining armor, but you know, yeah. Let's talk about it some more. I want to tap more to this tower. I want to go back into the tower. Let's talk about the tower. My time is doing good. 3237. I'm going to look that up before closing out. It's going to have significance in this energy. 3237. The Tower, Spirit. The Tower. Thank you. Someone's feeling weak in this energy. Can't make it up. It's an Emperor. They're feeling weak in this energy. Like Samson lost their strength. Let's talk about it. Strength card, Spirit. Oh yeah. It's the Emperor. For sure, right? We already knew that. That's overall energy. And their chance at being happy, they feel like it is a weak chance. Like this chance is not even existing right now. This is, you know, someone's joy gone wrong. Four of Wands. It's Four of Wands in the upright, but it's in the reverse. Four of Wands in reverse is about being, you know, in conflict or discord with someone and feeling insecure. This is insecurity. Split the deck. Insecure when it comes to a Ten of Pentacles energy. An Emperor is supposed to be the one, you know, that you look to for the legacy, for the building of a dynasty, an empire, you know. And in this energy, this Emperor is feeling weak and insecure. And at odds when it comes to their joy, their happiness, with the energy, because this is a homecoming card. This is a reunion. The Emperor wanted to reunite, I suppose, with an Empress, right? Let's talk about it some more. Uh-huh. Why is the Emperor here? Thank you. Mm-hmm. This is the Ten of Wands, and it's in the reverse. Mm-hmm. Ten of Wands in the reverse is somebody that just had a breakdown. Mm-hmm. They're burnt out. So much pressure. It's unbearable. That's what's going on in this energy. They're going through a tower. They're going through all of these catastrophic events right now, okay? So this Nine of Swords, Spirit, give us the Nine of Swords. Oh, okay. So you know what? Both of these want to go. We got to let them rot. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this person is feeling some type of way. Possible Libra energy. There's a Queen of Swords here that knows really about all of the lies, all of the deception. Yeah, see, here's the thing about these swords. These swords represent intelligence, mass communication with air vibration. Uh-huh. You know, you can't breathe, you can't talk, you can't walk without air. And it looks like that's what's going on with this Emperor energy. So we have the Moon that's in reverse. This is about someone just being deceptive. It also means a divorce, okay? But we got a Queen of Swords energy that is here, who someone wants a solid beginning with. Mm-hmm. The Emperor wants a solid beginning with this energy of a Queen of Swords. Possible Libra energy. However, check your charts, okay? For my cross watchers, I split the deck. There's a Knight of Pentacles that's in the reverse. Want to come through with a message, but can't pay the cost to be the boss, is what Spirit just told me. Wow. Let's talk about it some more, okay? I'm working through this fast because I want to get it out to you all, because when I give these reads, whatever it is that belongs to you, you take it for you and you dissect it for you and you use it to guide yourself out of this, okay? I'm here to give you, you know, insight and also to shed some light, my beautiful Sagittarius, okay? Let's talk about it some more. Six of Pentacles in the reverse. This is about giving to the wrong people, okay? Six of Pentacles, Sagittarius, okay. The Hangman, and the Hangman is in the reverse. You now see things from a whole nother perspective, uh-huh. Yeah, this person sees things in a whole nother way. They are asking themselves, what was I thinking? What was I thinking? When it should have been given to a Nine of Pentacles energy. Someone who can double up, triple up. Wow. Knight of Wands. Yeah, you in here, Sag. You all over the place. All these wands. Oh, there's too many cards. Putting these back in. Let's talk about it. Tell us about this Knight of Wands energy. And I want to tap into this Page of Swords too again. Oh, you know, I saw her, but she was going to make sure she came out. Now, this is the Queen of Wands in reverse, and this is woman is ruthless, okay? So we got a Queen of Swords with a Queen of Wands in reverse, okay? This is someone has fire in their chart. Possibly, right? Mm-hmm. But this is a very competitive. The Queen of Wands in reverse wants to compete. She's very jealous and envious. And she wanted to compete for a Ten of Pentacles energy. Ah, she wanted to reign on the throne, okay? When it came to this Ten of Pentacles energy. So this Queen of Wands energy, tell us about her. Tell us about the Queen of Wands spirit. Thank you. It's me. Thank you. Yeah, she turned her Wheel of Fortune upside down. I guess she was in the wrong park playing. This Wheel of Fortune is in the reverse. So, guess what that means? I mean, come on now. This Queen of Wands, she ain't sweet. Matter of fact, she's sour. Okay? All my clairs are open, beautiful ones. So when I visualize these energies and when I tap into the energy of who this is coming through, I can smell them. I can even taste them on my tongue. And she's sour. In my last reading, I said something I wouldn't normally say, and I channeled my grandmother there. But it was the truth, okay? And I'm always give you that, all right? So we're looking at this energy of someone competitive, feeling as if they have to win, and jealous, okay? Because the Queen of Wands in the reverse, in the upright, she's beautiful. So what this is telling me is that this individual is insecure. This is a very insecure energy. And she's insecure when it comes to the confidence of this Queen of Swords energy. Possible Libra energy again. Mm-hmm. And due to the insecurities and the jealousy now, and also outside influencing, like this person is, you know, elevator doesn't go all the way to the top. You can influence them really easy. You know, it's like, hey, you know, I got a lollipop. You want one? Meet me round back. You know what I mean? It's that type of energy. And, you know, the Queen of Wands is in reverse, so she's rolling on down the road to get the lollipop, right? So, you know, if I can draw that scenario to let you know how gullible, you know, this energy is while practicing being jealous and envious, okay? They have gave themselves major setbacks and really what we would say in the spiritual realm is curse their bloodline with bad luck. Uh-huh. Put an interruption into the flow of their own destiny by trying to manipulate destiny. Let's talk about it. Oh, look, overall energy is the Ace of Pentacles. And they did it for the Ace of Pentacles. Wow. Interesting, because this person wanted a new beginning. They wanted a new beginning with an emperor. And it's clear that the emperor did not want that same new beginning. Wheel of Fortune in reverse, spirit. Thank you. Yeah, this is someone who pretty much, they were refusing. I mean, absolutely refusing to be real, to be open. This person is beyond, you know, greedy. Yeah, because this is about someone just recklessly spending money and recklessly being financially insecure. So this person doesn't make money. This person can't provide for themselves. This is a codependent energy who relies on the pentacles of others in order for them to survive. So this is an energy of, wow. And it's the King of Pentacles energy, the father, possible baby daddy that was flipping the bill. Mm-hmm. And it's because they were in balance. King of Cups. They feel some type of way about it too. Yeah. Other people were benefiting from this King of Pentacles. Four of Pentacles, Spirit. Sag. Sagittarius. I'm going to take them. Just how they came out. Wow. Come on now. Come on. Like that, though. Spirit, thank you. As I said, this was a King of Pentacles, somebody's father, somebody's grandfather, somebody's baby daddy, who was imbalanced with his emotions, okay? Jealous, just like the Queen of Wands. Yeah. See, the King of Pentacles is the energy in the upright that would normally be, you know, fortunate and wealth and all the good things you want to see in your baby daddy, right? But their inner shadow side, which is this King of Cups that's in reverse. This King of Cups in reverse is someone who is unreliable. They're a thief. They're crafty. She's crafty. Yeah, that's what they call them. Crafty. And they're overwhelmed because they don't have any boundaries. They let people run all over them. And now they know what the rundown really was about. They got ran down. Overall energy by a Queen of Pentacles. Someone they wifed up. Someone they probably gave a baby to. That is a liar. They are not the truth. We got the Sun in reverse. And they played with their head and brought forth illusions, played mind games with all the lies. It could be a Temperance energy. Sagittarius, is that you? Let's step into this energy. Ooh, we all on it. Foot down, okay? Like Archangel Michael. Okay, it's a lot going on, Sagittarius. Okay, I'm gonna pull a couple of more cards before closing out. I hope this is giving you insight. Anything that you had a question about, Spirit has delivered it immaculately, okay? I'm loving it. And I'm sending love to you. Page of Swords, Spirit. Page of Swords. For Sagittarius. Thank you. Yeah, Page of Swords. They've made a decision. Okay? They're not in their head anymore when it comes to an Empress. Yeah. Decisions have been made. King of Swords. Sagittarius, you're in the energy of cutting people off, and you've done so in many ways. I'm seeing what's going on because you're not playing. I split the deck. You want your Ace of Cups. You want your new love. And your new love is looking like an Empress. That's what your new love looks like. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful awakening, right? That's what we would call it, an awakening. You've gone through an awakening, okay? Let's talk about it because there's still a lot of stuff going on, all right? Two of Swords, tell us what else. Tell us what else about the Two of Swords. Two of Swords, Spirit. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, so you have to fight for this new beginning. People were competing with you. Sagittarius, take what is yours and leave what isn't. But people were in competition about you and your new life. They saw that you wanted a new beginning, and they would do anything to stop you, play mind games, and trip you up about it. Overall energy. King of Swords. Cut them off. Get like your girl. Stunting is a habit. Get like me. Yeah. Possible Libra energy you're dealing with, okay? We got the Empress out here as well. All right. Libra, more balancing of the scales that's going on. All right, let's pull a couple of more cards before closing out my beautiful Sagittarius. Wow. Y'all spicy. Okay. Tell us more about the death spirit. The death. Death card for Sag. Okay. Wow. Justice is in reverse. So someone doesn't want to face their karma. I never get that. I just never get that when justice comes out in reverse. Like, who do you think you are? No, it doesn't happen like that. But this means that you've been very dishonest, okay? And that you're unbalanced. This is the energy of feeling unbalanced, okay? And feeling like there was some unfair treatment. And it looks like a whole lot of unfair treatment in this energy, Sag. Overall energy, somebody feels like it's not fair. I'm not gonna have this Ten of Pentacles dream. Justice in reverse. It was getting a little wild on me. Justice in reverse. Thank you, Spirit. All right. We'll take this last one and close out. Judgment. Can't escape the karma because the Most High comes down and delivers the judgment. I think people forget about that part. Overall energy is a temperance energy. All right. Some healing. Okay. I hope that there is some healing going on. All right. There's certainly a lot of retrospect and introspection happening. And possible, you know, watching the Empress from afar as well. Yeah. Watching the Empress from afar, like I said. Thinking about that Ten of Pentacles energy. Woulda, coulda, shoulda. But instead, it was this. Eight of Swords. Okay, let's talk about it some more before closing up. I cannot close this out without giving some beautiful botanical oracle. Some beautiful energy. Beautiful ones. 3734. Let me look that up before we close out. My beautiful Sagittarius, I love you. Let's look up 3734 to see what that message is for you all. Because I know it has everything to do. That was what was on the timer, remember? Okay? Yeah. Let's talk about this angel number. If you guys have not already looked it up, I am looking it up for you. I'm going to try to incorporate that instead of, you know, yelling it out. Because when I see a number, that number is a direct message from source. Okay? So let's talk about 3734, angel number, all right? And this is on the Sun Sign Signs org.org app, okay? Do you know that 3734 spiritually means spiritually? Angel number, spiritual meaning represents success, positive energy, intuition, and growth. Therefore, the true meaning of this numerology indicates that it's time to be creative and unleash your best potential to the universe. With the presence of the master number, 33, angels warn you to follow other people's paths. They warn you of following other people's paths. With the presence of this master number, okay, because it breaks down to 33. It warns you of following other people's paths. You are reminded to trust fully in your decisions and your choices. This is the only road that will turn your vision into reality. Besides, don't be afraid of spreading your wings. If you seem to remain in one project with no progress, take time to scrutinize what is around you. Who is around you? 3734 symbolizes assist you to unleash your potential in no time. So beautiful Sagittarius, I'm asking you, okay, to meditate on this number, write this number down, do some scribing tomorrow in 1111's portal, okay? It will be November 11th tomorrow, and it will be an extra dose of activation for a manifestation. Work with the number 3734, okay? Wow, spirit is speaking beautifully. Yeah, let's go ahead and get you some cards. I'll make it a little more spicy before we head on out. Oh my goodness, I ain't gonna hold you. You know, I have to make light of these situations because, come on now, you don't grow from staying in the dark. So I'm always gonna make some light. Spirit, give me cards for Sagittarius. Cards for Sagittarius. This is my makeshift card. Somebody's been drinking and thinking. Cut it out. That's that devil energy keeping you in low vibration. Drinking and thinking. More cards, Spirit. Okay, thank you. Hole in the wall bar. Somebody's been hanging out at the local hole in the wall bar. Cut it out. Ain't nothing but devil energies in there. Somebody by the name of Mike might even be in there, okay? Tempting you to stay in a low vibration. Thank you, Spirit. Motorcycle. Could be a motorcycle club. You may have a motorcycle or know someone that rides a motorcycle. And they need gas money. They don't have gas money for the motorcycle. They need to go ahead and put that up. Spirit. Someone may be born in Chicago as well. Somebody is Chicago born. Let's talk about it. More cards for Sag. Take what is yours and leave what isn't. Beautiful ones. Okay, we're going to get a couple more out and close out. All right. These messages are very serious. Okay. I'm going to leave it right there. Leave it right there. At needs gas money. That can be some inspiration for somebody to just get it. Go get it, okay? But move with integrity. Somebody may have Louisiana ties, okay? Somebody may know an earth angel who is from Louisiana. Yeah. Earth angel energy is here. Your ancestors are also assisting you, okay? Let that shit go. Whatever it is that you know you need to let it go. Because they crashed out. There was a real life crash dummy. And again, Chicago born energy is out here, like I said. And there was a dirty money scam that someone probably could have gotten involved in. And guess what? They didn't know someone had magician in their bloodline. They didn't know that. My beautiful Sagittarius, thank you for allowing me to provide your read. Make sure you hit that like button, okay? Become a subscriber and help the dynasty grow. Because we in here. I am Empress 444. And this is the Tarot.